What is up, everybody? Steve Jackson here with Evolve Guitar. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Foo Fighters song, The Pretender, one of my favorite Foo Fighters songs. Hey, if you have suggestions for other tutorials you'd like to see, go ahead and leave that in the comments below. And if you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. The first chord shape that we're going to play is going to sound kind of like this. So what we're doing here is we're holding down the 10th fret of the D string with our ring finger, the 9th fret of the G, 10th fret of the B with our pinky, and then the pointer finger is going to grab the 7th fret of the high E string. And we're just going to start at the A string, and we're going to pick all the way down, and then back up till we get to D. So that's the first thing we're going to do. After that, we're going to release our pointer finger off that high E string, and we're going to kind of move it around. So the next thing we're going to do is play the open A. Then we're going to grab the 7th fret of the low E string, kind of a stretch there. And then we're going to strum the rest of these strings starting at the D string going down. So then we're going to move this pointer finger up one fret to 8. We're going to strum again. Then we're going to play open A, strum again. And then we're gonna grab 9 on the A string, a little awkward feeling there too. And then we're gonna pick down to the D and the G and the B. So. Then we're gonna pick this 9 again and we're gonna bend it. And then bring it down to 8. And then we're gonna pick all the way down and then back up again. So let's do that whole thing. So that's the intro, and that's actually Dave Grohl's part. I'm gonna show you Dave Grohl's part that comes up next, and then after that, I'll show you the other guitar part, which is Chris Shiflett, the rhythm guitar player. But what Dave Grohl's gonna do next in the kind of pre-chorus section is play this A minor chord, and we're just gonna strum it twice, and then we're gonna pause. Then we're gonna do it 4 times, and then pause again. And that's really the strumming pattern for this whole section. Then we're gonna move to this D slash F sharp chord. So right, D, and then we're gonna grab the low E string, 2nd fret with our thumb. Same pattern. Then we're gonna move to this chord here. So it's like a C chord without the middle finger here on the D string. We're gonna instead put our pinky on the D string 3rd fret. It plays through that several times, and then it just takes out the rests in between and it starts just strumming it normally. So Chris Shiflett's part that comes in sounds like this. So what he's doing here, it's pretty simple and it just repeats a lot. So I'm grabbing the 5th fret of the B string, and then we're also going to play the open E string throughout this whole part. It's just going to ring open. So we're going to start off by playing the 5th fret 2 times, and then the 7th fret once, and then back to 5. So 5, 5, 7, 5. Then we're just going to go 8, and then 5, 5, 5. And that's all there is to it. It just repeats that. It does it pretty quick. Then right before it gets into the chorus, he starts playing these octaves kind of leading up into the chorus. So what he's doing there is he's playing the 5th fret of the A and 7th fret of the G. We're just strumming that 4 times. We got that muted D string in the middle, right? I'm muting that with my pointer finger here. I'm moving up 2 frets to 7 and 9 and playing that 4 times. Then moving up to 9 and 11 4 times. And then moving up 1 fret from there to 10 and 12. So now in the chorus section here, what Chris Shiflett's gonna play is actually almost exactly the same thing that we played in the intro. It's that same chord shape, but basically what we're gonna do is strum the whole thing instead of picking individual notes. So we're gonna start off by playing this 10 on the D, 9 on the G, and 10 on the B, and we're gonna leave the high E string open, and we're just gonna strum this 16 times. So you can think of it like 4 groups of 4, 2 groups of 8. Okay, then after that, we're gonna add in the open A string. We're gonna play that twice. Then we're gonna go to our next chord shape, which was that 7th fret low E string. We're gonna play this 4 times as well. Then we're gonna move it up 1 fret to 8 and play that 4 times. Then we got our open A shape. We're gonna do this 4 times. Then we're gonna add in that 9th fret A string and play that. So the way you wanna count this is you kinda play it once, and then you play a group of 16. Then we're just gonna move it down 1 fret. Same thing, we're gonna play a group of 16 there. The next part he plays sounds kind of like this. So it's kind of like a blues riff here. So what we're doing is we're playing the open A string, we're playing the 2nd fret of the D, and we're playing this 2 times. And then we're just gonna go to the 4th fret of the D string, we're gonna leave the open A, and then we're gonna play just open A, so. Then we're gonna go up to the 5th fret of the D, open A, then the 4th fret D with the open A also, and then back to the 2nd. And we're just going to repeat that. Then a little later, there's a slight variation, almost the same part, but we're going to start off by doing the open A and the 2nd fret D again, 2 times, and then 4, back to open A, and then 5th fret D. So all this is really pretty much the same, but then we're going open A again. Now the different part is we're gonna move up to 7 on the D and still open A. So. And then back down to the 2nd fret there. So basically just that, and he's gonna start repeating that pattern. And at the very end of the song, he changes it up one more time. He's doing a similar idea, still playing the open A, moving around the D string. But now we're gonna be all the way up on the 10th fret. So we're gonna do that 2 times, and go to 9, and then open A, so. And then down to 7, and then to 5, and then open one more time. And we're just gonna repeat that. And then at the end, we're just gonna grab this A minor bar chord, and we're gonna go 2 times and then rest, and then 4 times and rest.